At IFA 2024, MSI has introduced new designs to their laptop lineup, and they have Intel flavors and AMD flavors. So let's take a quick look. First up on the lineup, we have the MSI Prestige 16 AI Plus Evo. Technically B2VM model right here. Features an Intel Core Ultra 9 processor, which I'm seeing on the placard here is labeled as 288V. I did not take the Lunar Lake briefing, so I actually don't know what that means for this model. This is news to me, so I gotta look into that. Maybe go read an article over by Mark Hockman, link in the description. This is up to a 16-inch UHD Plus panel, so it's technically 4K, but a little taller, so 16 by 10. So the pixels are 3840 by 2400. That's a lot of pixels. 100% DCI P3 coverage, and it does have an optional OLED attached to it. Now, this is the same chassis that has been in previous models, but they does have some slight tweaks for this new design. First off, the cooling has been tweaked slightly for Lunar Lake, but it is very similar with the fans and the heat pipes. But the biggest thing is going to be the webcam up here. They have upgraded the webcam to 5 megapixels and with a nice little privacy shutter, a physical privacy shutter that you switch on and off here. Now, unfortunately, I have no pricing and availability information at this point, but MSI does tell me that that information will come out in a couple months and definitely by the end of the year, so look out for that one. Next up, down the line, we here have the Prestige 14 AI Plus Evo C2VM. So this is similar to the 16-inch that we just saw, but a couple more tweaks. This one is up to a Core Ultra 7 processor, and the actual model denotes as 258V. So we'll have to look that up as well. Up to 14-inch, 2.8K, which is 2880 by 1800. So it is a 16 by 10 panel, 120 hertz, 100% DC P3 color gamut, OLED optional, all the same stuff. And once again, the new upgraded webcam to 5 megapixels with the nice little switch. So the styling is very similar, but it also has its own unique touches too. Like the actual backplate here has this little like raindrop kind of design. It's nice. Once again, I don't have the pricing and availability for this model as well, so we will have to see it at a later date. Let's continue down the line, and we have the Prestige 13 AI Plus Evo 82VM. So if you couldn't if you couldn't have guessed, this is the 13-inch model of the same series. So a lot of the same things apply, and even down at this 13-inch, we're still getting a 16 by 10 display, up to an OLED panel. And of course, the big claim to fame for this one is 990 grams with this magnesium aluminum alloy chassis. And this thing, believe me, is light. So if you're looking for the thinnest, lightest, smallest experience, this one is going to be very nice. So that's it for the Prestige line. Let's come down here to one more laptop in an Intel configuration. This is the Summit 13 AI Plus Evo A2VM. Now, the big thing about this chassis is that it is a 2-in-1 option. So if you are like Gordon and you like to be able to prop it up or maybe put it in a tent mode to watch all your movies, then this is the laptop for you. It comes in a very, very stylish case with these gold accents. But the 13-inch screen, this comes in an option of Full HD Plus, so 1920 by 1200, 100% sRGB, not DCI P3, and it does support the MSI Pen 2. So the upgraded webcam is also in this as well, 5 megapixels. So this is for somebody who's maybe a little bit more business-minded and really wants that style. So that's it for the new Intel Lunar Lake options from MSI. But on the other side, we have AMD. So let's go over here. So on this side, MSI has 4 different models of AMD options. This first one is the Summit A16 AI Plus A3HM. So this is similar to the Summit that's on the other side, but it can hold up to a AMD Ryzen AI9 365 processor. That is already reviewed Ryzen AI 300. You can go watch Gordon's testing up in the right corner. But this is a 16-inch screen with a 2560 by 1600, still 16 by 10, but this one has a 165 hertz refresh rate, still 100% DCI-P3 color gamut IPS display that supports MSI Pen 2. So this one, for me, is not only going to be good at your daily usage because it is thin and light, Ryzen AI 300 does have some actual chops to do editing as well. So this one kind of solidly falls kind of in between depending on what you want to do, but so does the other one. Next up is the AMD option for the Prestige line. This is the Prestige AI 16 AI Plus A3 HM. So this also goes up to a Ryzen AI 9 365 processor, and the Pandu configuration is actually a little bit higher at 3840 by 2400, but the same DCI-P3 color gamut and all the goodness that you can get from the Summit, but in a different chassis with this Prestige. I will also point out that I do like that these 16-inch laptops all come with number pads. I am a big fan of number pads, and MSI includes number pads on their 16-inch laptops, so big thumbs up from me. Continuing down the line, this is one that is definitely near and dear to my heart. This is the MSI Creator A16 AI Plus, model number A3XV or A3HV. This goes up to a Ryzen AI 9 HX 370 processor, so this is a little bit higher wattage part. Not only that, this does come with a discrete GPU option. So this can get up to an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4070 laptop GPU, and it comes pre-installed with studio drivers. This is for content creation. This is the kind of laptop I have always used in the past, being a video editor myself. So not only is it important to have the power, you know, the powerful system in here, but for any content creation laptop worth its salt, it's all about the screen and being able to reproduce accurate colors. So this is a up to 16-inch Quad HD Plus, so 2560 by 1600, 16 by 10 panel. It does get up to 240 hertz refresh rate, but honestly, that is overkill for me. 100% DCI P3 color gamut coverage, and it does have an OLED option. Now, I also did talk with AMD about calibration with third-party sources, and they do tell me something that I didn't quite know, is that if you look on this placard here, they certify this as a true pixel display, and what that means is that they actually worked with Kalman to certify the display against, but this true pixel is their actual own branding on it. So it is, they do work with Kalman to verify the color representation of this screen, and that is definitely a big deal for these content creation laptops. So unfortunately, no price and availability on this one, but I am hoping to get my hands on this one because I do like these content creation laptops. Let's move on down to the very last laptop we have here, which is the MSI Stealth A16 AI Plus A3XV, A3HV. Which has a similar configuration. Both of these are actually a very similar chassis design, but one is aimed more at gaming, one is aimed more at content creation. The specs are similar, up to a Ryzen AI 9 HX 370 processor with up to an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4070 laptop GPU, but it comes pre-installed with the gaming drivers instead of the studio drivers. So for panel options, it is once again very similar to the Creator over there, up to a 2560 by 1600 display, 16 by 10, 240 hertz refresh rate, 100% DCI P3 color gamut, and an OLED optional. But this one is not Kalman verified, or it doesn't have the true pixel badge on it. And I asked MSI why, and they said, listen, it's the same panel that's in both. It is a damn good panel, but they, in order to get the Kalman verification for those creators, it goes through a lot of testing and a lot of checks. And for gaming, you just don't need that. So it is a similar panel, but you just don't need something that's like super rigorously tested the way that you do for content creation. So it should still be a very good panel. And once again, I do not have pricing and availability on this laptop, but if it's any indication, this might be a hot seller because for some reason, Tom's Hardware gave it Best in Show. Tom's Hardware? No, we're not. I'm just gonna put this off to the side. We don't need to see that. We'll just pretend we got a PC World thing here. Just kidding. No. That's okay. I like these guys. They're nice. So that's it for the new models that MSI has at IFA 2024. Like I said, most of these will be coming out by the end of the year, so you'll have to look out for independent reviews when those do come. Go over to PCWorld.com for the actual written reviews, but if you want to watch more video coverage of laptops, desktops, even the MSI Claw 8 AI Plus, be sure to subscribe here on PC World for more hardware goodness.